I understand the business, and I know what I'm supposed to do. To have a good ear, a good hand, and a good head is necessary for a villain. This is a good opportunity for me to thrive. I've been getting a lot of rewards today, but with this, I could get more. Being a villain, I already know everything, and this plan just fell nicely into my lap. Ariel is trying to run away and get married to a human without King Trison knowing. I could tell the king, but that goes against everything I believe in. I'm going to keep it to myself, so I can remain a villain. I'm going to hide. Oh look, here's another opportunity for me now. Here come two fish. Every school, every shop, every ocean, I listen and pay attention for something I can get out of it.
See what you did? There's another way to tell King Trine that Ariel isn't in the ocean, she's up on land.
No. Listen to me.
No, you listen to me.
Okay, tell me.
Because Ariel is not a part of your flesh and blood, because she's not a part of your family, you have not offended the king and cannot be punished by him. Show him the charges you found about her. The human things that she brought from the land back down to the ocean after every visit. This being done, he has to believe you.
I will tell the king everything. I will explain Ariel's reasoning for going up there. She has not been honest to her father or to me.
Yeah, Ariel hasn't been honest, but we still have to stick up for her and tell the king it's okay for her to go on land so we don't get in trouble by telling her to do so.
Clever idea, fish.
Let's go to the king so we can make him think about this.
I know what they're talking about because I used to be very good friends with King Triton.
Hopefully he's at the kingdom.
I am not always honest, but I can be. Let me take off my jacket so they don't recognize me.
Hello, fish. Where are you going?
To the kingdom, if you must know.
I can tell by the box you're bringing with you that you're doing something very important there. Where you're from, your names, your ages, and anything else that you think King Triton is worthy of knowing, you should tell him.
We are just plain fish.
That is a lie. You are not clean cut, you're dirty. Don't lie to me. Lying never ends well.
You probably have told us a lie if you're trying to protect the king.
You are a courtier, aren't you?
Yes, I'm an advisor to the king. Don't I look like it? Don't I have the air of a royal advisor? Do I not look down on your humble status? I'm a courtier from head to toe. If I offer to help you, I will benefit in the end. I demand you to tell me why you are going to the kingdom.
My business, ma'am, is to the king.
Who is your advocate?
I do not have one.
Advocate is a court word for salmon. Say you don't have one.
I don't have a salmon, marlin, or swordfish.
We are so blessed that we are not simple fish. Nature made me a strong courtier, so I will not treat you as unworthy.
She's a great companion to King Triton.
Her clothes are rich, and she wears them elegantly.
She's a great person, I can tell.
Why do you have that box with you? What's inside?
There are belongings and secrets in that box that no one can know about except King Triton. I can show him that very soon, if you allow me to see him.
You can't do that anymore.
Why?
The king is not at the kingdom. He has gone aboard a ship to try to become happy again. King Triton is full of grief.
Yes, we heard that his daughter keeps going up on land. She wants to marry a human.
If Sebastian, Ariel's best friend, who apparently has been supporting her decision, is not arrested, he will curse him and torture him. And Sebastian will have the heart of a sea monster.
Really? You think so?
He is furious and bitter. This fish is supporting Ariel, and her dangerous decisions infuriates the king. Some say Sebastian will be fed to the sharks. But I think he'd be getting away easy if that's how the king chooses to handle things.
Is there anyone else who's been assisting Ariel in betraying her father?
Yes, another one of her friends, Flounder. He will be covered in algae and thrown into a group of stingrays. Then, when he has been stung multiple times, he will be set against a coral wall with the sun directly
life out of him. But why are we talking about these little rascals who are suffering? Are supposed to be smiled at, and since their actions were endangering? If you guys are really honest fish, you will tell me what you're bringing to King Triton. If it is something I think he needs to see, I will take you to his ship and give you good reputations so you can talk to him there.
She seems to be of high authority. Bargain with her. Even though loyalty to the king is supposed to be her number one priority, you can usually get around that by giving her a couple of sand dollars. We need to tell the king that we are good fish. Give her money so we aren't fed to sharks and stung by stingrays.
Here are the sand dollars I have. I'll make it more for you if you tell the king we are honest and loyal.
After I do what I have promised?
Yes.
Well, give me what you have now. Are you going to participate in this as well?
I will try to. I don't have as much to offer, but I will try.
Oh, that's how Flounder is, too. When he is killed, he'll be made an example.
That cannot happen. We need to show the king the treasures we are bringing to him. They will prove that Ariel can swim up to land and come back down safely without anything bad happening to her. The king will know that we would never let his daughter do something he thought was wrong, and he will forgive us. I'll give you as many sand dollars as he does after your promise is performed exactly how you say it will be.
I will trust you. Swim toward the seaside and go right. I'm going to this coral reef for a second, but I will follow you guys after.
We are blessed to have this girl, really blessed.
Let's do what she told us to do. She wants us to be good.
If I had a desire, to be honest, I would still somehow be rewarded. Money is dropped in my lap. I now have two ways to be rewarded. Sand dollars, and for King Triton to reward me with a position of high authority. Who knows how much that could help me? I will bring these two oblivious fish to him. If he thinks that what they have to show him is useless, he will be rid of them, but he will still pay me. I will bring them to him, and I might get something out of it.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, darling.